Hi, I'm David Eisenberg, author of Web Development with ReasonML. In this video, I'd like to show you a little bit of one of ReasonML's greatest features, its type system. Let's write a function that concatenates an exclamation point to its string argument. We'll let exclaim be a function that takes a message as its parameter, and the body returns the message plus plus, which is concatenation, and an exclamation point. Reason is strongly typed, but I didn't have to manually declare that exclaim was a function that takes a string argument and returns a string result. The editor I'm using is displaying the result of Reason's type inference system, which figured that out all on its own. Reason enforces this typing. Let's call the function correctly. Let good result equals exclaim. It works. And again, the type inference has determined the result is a string. If we make a call with an incorrect argument, for example, using an integer instead of a string, Reason tells us we have a problem with our types. Reason's type inference is so good that you rarely need to manually specify type information, unless you want to. You aren't limited to Reason's built-in data types, such as integer, float, string, and boolean. In Reason, you can create your own data types. Here's a type that defines shirt sizes by specifying a type, the name of the type, and the possible values it can have. I can now create variables of that type and assign them a value. Let's let my size equal medium. And again, Reason has inferred the correct type. If you try to assign a value that isn't valid, ReasonML stops you. If I try to let bad size equals extra small, I get an error message. Here's a function that returns the price of a shirt given its size. In this case, I've explicitly specified the type information for the parameter and for the return value. This function uses pattern matching, where I specify all the possible values and the results for those values. When using pattern matching, Reason makes sure at compile time that you've covered all the cases. If I were to get rid of large, Reason would stop me and tell me I'm missing one of the possible values. Data types that you make yourself are also type checked. If you use an incorrect type, Reason will catch that error. Reason's type system moves a whole class of errors from runtime to compile time, ensuring that your program's users will never see them. The ability to define your own data types gives you expressive power to let your code reflect your data structures. These are just some of the things that make Reason a great choice for developers. If you find this intriguing, read more about it in Web Development with ReasonML.